afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, family members and friends of the class of 2017. I ask that you please take your seats. My name is Paul Carty, and I am the principal of Archbishop Stepanak High School. Thank you. This is a day of special joy and pride for you and the Archbishop Stepanak community as we add 173 young men to the ranks of our alumni. Today we honor these young men for their 4 years of dedication and hard work. I ask you to please stand while the graduates and faculty proceed down the aisle. Cue the music. honored guests, members of the administration and faculty, parents, sponsors, relatives, friends, and graduates of the class of 2017, I am pleased and honored to welcome you to the 67th commencement of Archbishop Stepanak High School. To begin our graduation exercises, I ask you to remain standing while Mrs. Maria Buda delivers the invocation. After the invocation, please join us in singing our national anthem, led by Dominique Burke, Anthony Pietro Luongo, and Mark DeSanctis.
Good afternoon. If we can take a moment and remember that we are in the presence of God. We begin this as we begin all things of import in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In the Gospel of Luke, it's written, "To whom much is given, much is required." Graduates, God has given you so many gifts. Intellectual gifts in the classroom, athletic talents on the fields and in the courts, acting, singing, dancing on the stage, the gift of good friends, good teachers, coaches, mentors, and of course, loving families. As you have been given these gifts, so Stepanak has been both the nurturer of these gifts, assisting in your growth from boys to young men, as well as the recipients, as your contributions to the school community have enriched us all. God has blessed you with so much. He expects that you take what you have learned and who you have become in your 4 years here, go out to your respective colleges and universities and beyond, and use your talents for the betterment of yourselves and the world around you. In the Gospel of John, it says, "I shall no longer call you servants, because a servant doesn't know the master's business. I call you my friends, because I have made known to you everything I've learned from my Father." In a few moments, when the diplomas are received, you won't be students anymore, but Stepanak alumni. And as such, your relationship with all of us at Stepanak will change. As Jesus called his disciples friends when they were prepared to go forth into the world, so we call you. We at Stepanak have given you the best of what we possess while you were here. We now send you on with confidence and faith that you are now prepared for the future hold as our friends. In Ephesians, it says, "God has more in store for you than you can ever imagine." Lastly, no one knows the future, but with firm faith, you believe that God has you always in his care. He's with you throughout everything, and that his plan for you in his mind for all eternity. If you realize
dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the rampart we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bomb bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. Now that we have honored our country, I want to acknowledge two seniors who will serve our country after graduation. I ask them to stand when their name is called. Entering the United States Army, Vidal Harrington. and joining the Air National Guard, Eddie Villalobos. It is my pleasure to present to you the salutatorian for the class of 2017, Mr. Julio Lazo.
Good afternoon. I am honored to welcome you to Stepanek's Class of 2017 graduation ceremony. I still remember the first day of orientation, freshman year. I walked into the auditorium and there were so many students. I was a little scared because it was a whole new environment. By the first day of school, I still was not familiar with the whole building and I got lost trying to find the locker room for gym. I'll never forget that day. Just as I was feeling scared that day, many of us are feeling the same today. But that sense of apprehension is mixed with excitement and happiness. I am honored to be graduating from Stepanek. I've made so many friends and memories that I will never forget. The life lessons taught here will allow me to be successful in college. In fact, one of the posters in Ms. Bazonia's class says, "There are no mistakes, only lessons." Our teachers have not only prepared us for college, but for wherever the future leads us. They have brought out the best in me, and I can't thank them enough for helping me reach this moment. I'm actually the first in my family to reach this moment. High school graduate and college bound. My parents were born in Ecuador, and they didn't have the opportunity to attend high school. They have worked hard to make sure that my brother and I have more opportunities than they had. My dad has always told me that nada es imposible, nothing is impossible. This couldn't be more true. My parents had to build up their lives from nothing with little to no support. They made it possible for me to get a great education. I have not taken this opportunity in vain. I've made my parents proud by graduating as salutatorian. I'm an example of how you can make something from nothing. I want to be a role model for younger students, especially for my brothers, and show them that if I have accomplished this, they can too. Stepanek has shown me my strengths and what I'm capable of doing. It has shown all of you the same as well, and I encourage you to not fall below those standards. Fellow graduates, thank you for making these past years unforgettable. Some memories will fade away, but others will remain forever. Thank you to the teachers for not giving up on us and reminding us to seize each moment. Thank you to administration for always having the students' best interest in heart. Thank you to our parents, because without their unconditional love, we would not be here. You all have borne witness to our growth from teenagers to young men, ready to conquer the world. Since it is Ascension Thursday, I would like to end with a Bible verse from Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." That is my prayer for the class of 2017. Thank you.
We are pleased to present one of our awards to the graduating senior, a little out of sequence. The New York State Attorney General, Eric Schneiderman, presents the Triple C Award to graduating seniors in each school. The Triple C stands for Commitment, Character, and Courage. We are pleased that Mr. Matthew Feinberg, an attorney from the Attorney General's office, is here to present this award to Andrew Bach.
Good afternoon. My name is Matt Feinberg. I'm an Assistant Attorney General in the New York State Attorney General's Office. And on behalf of Attorney General Eric Schneiderman, it's a privilege and honor to be here today on such a joyful occasion. We also item and is honored to be able to carry on the tradition. Motivated by his strong belief that he benefited from all the education he received, the support and encouragement he encountered from his parents, educators, and other adults he admired, Attorney General Schneiderman wants to ensure that this generation of students will be recognized for their own achievements. The Triple C program is one such way to acknowledge and encourage those hardworking New York students who have distinguished themselves within their school and community with their character, courage, and commitment. Being selected by their school for this prestigious award is indicative of these students' steadfast commitment to academic excellence and the respect they have earned throughout the community. They have truly earned today's recognition. Therefore, I am honored to present the Triple C Award to Andrew Bosch. Thank you all. God bless.
The first of today's awards are being given to individuals for their outstanding commitment and service to Archbishop Stepanak High School. The first award is the Sequeri Dam Award. The title of the Sequeri Dam Award, taken from the coat of arms of Stepanak's founder, Cardinal Spellman, means follow God. The recipient of the award is one who has followed the Lord's mandate to love one another in an extraordinary manner. Father Thomas Collins graduated from Stepanak in 1979 and returned here 22 years ago. He taught religion when he first returned, then took on the role of campus minister. He also served as the dean of students and then became involved in the advancement office, where he was in charge of raising funds for the school. 6 years ago, he was asked to become the president of the school, the first alumnus to do so. In his role as president, Father Collins is both the chief executive officer of the school and is responsible for ensuring that our mission is clearly fulfilled. He also spends significant time meeting with our alumni to share the good news of Stepanak and to ask them for their continued support. To be honest, this is not the easiest of tasks. However, Father Tom does so with a unique grace and humility. Countless alumni bear witness to his unabashed love for Stepanak, and this inspires them to remain committed to our school's mission. Therefore, through Father Tom's leadership, the school continues to grow and thrive. But Father Collins' greatest impact on the school is in his role as a priest. His greatest joy is when he is able to celebrate the sacraments of the school community, to lead us in prayer, worship, and service. And as we saw last Tuesday evening, he is particularly gifted homilies, finding ways to make the gospel message palpable to the young and old alike. Father Collins has just celebrated his 25th anniversary of ordination to the priesthood. We thank him for his vocation, no matter the role or title, and for his priestly ministry. In celebration and thanksgiving, we are delighted to present to him the Sequeri Deum Award. The Inte Domine Speravi Award. Archbishop Stepanak, our patron, chose as his episcopal motto the Latin phrase Inte Domine Speravi, in thee, O Lord, have I hope. Because of his strong faith in his God and his firm adherence to his moral principles, Archbishop Stepanak is the ultimate example of loyalty, perseverance, and faith. The Inte Domine Speravi Award has been established to honor those individuals who most exemplify the personal qualities and values that Archbishop Stepanak exhibited during his lifetime. We are pleased this year to present the award to Mr. John Cunningham of the class of 1955. A lifelong Westchester resident, John spent his childhood in Yonkers and has lived in Mount Kisco for many years. After 4 memorable years at Stepanak, he fondly remembers playing football with an incredible group of teammates on the 54 squad. He made several postseason teams, including CHSFL All-League team, All-County, New York Post, and Daily News, and the All-Catholic Journal American. John was elected to Stepanak's Gridiron Club in 2014. Additionally, John ran track and was involved in Meeting Europe. He earned his bachelor's degree at Fordham University and a master's degree at NYU. He was lucky enough to marry Mary Finnegan of Liskeay, Ireland. They have 4 children and 5 grandchildren. One of his grandchildren, Luke, is graduating today. After a 30-year career at IBM, ending as a corporate controller in 1994, John went on to become the CFO of Whirlpool Corporation before ending the business side of life as CFO and operations officer at Citrix Systems. He has also worked on the board of directors for Sony Networks. Throughout his entire career and life, John has never forgotten his alma mater. He still, to this day, remains one of our most generous benefactors. With pride and gratitude for his support, Archbishop Stepanak High School is pleased to present the E.J. Dominic Ferravia Award to Mr. John Cunningham. Block S Award. Each year we seek to recognize individuals whose contributions have had a meaningful impact on the school. We present these individuals with the Block S Award, a symbol of the school that they have faithfully served. At the graduation mass on Tuesday, we honor 10 parents for their service to the students. I would like to acknowledge them again and ask that they stand as they call their names. Joseph Alfredo, Victor DiDario, Joviana Mercado, Tom and Kim Nevin, Marty O'Neill, Josie Ralph, Neil Scalante, and James and Nancy Walsh. Today, we honor 2 members of the school community for their service to the school and students. Being a school counselor is difficult work, but the impact that counselors have on students makes the profession very rewarding. Everyone agrees that effective school counselors must be a good listener, be able to assess students' strengths, challenges, interests, and abilities, be an excellent communicator, appreciate diversity, and be well-rounded. Archbishop Stepanak High School is blessed that Mrs. Cynthia Kilkelly possesses all of these skills and more. A parent of a student graduating today recently told me how much he and his wife appreciated Mrs. Kilkelly's work with their son. In his words, Mrs. Kilkelly made us feel as if our son was the only student with whom she was working. She was completely focused on him and helped him make the best choice for his college selection. This is in large part due to the fact that Mrs. Kilkelly always has such keen insights into our students. To paraphrase Psalm 119, her words are a lamp to their feet and a light to their path. Mrs. Kilkelly is known for unearthing talents in our students and encouraging their exploration. She began the healthcare forum as a means of allowing students with an enthusiasm for health sciences to discern their field of interest. Most importantly, Mrs. Kilkelly knows how to balance tough love with genuine understanding and compassion. She knows how to be honest and forthcoming while still preserving each student's hopes and dreams. Mrs. Kilkelly is there with hands to applaud their moments of victory, and she is there with a shoulder to lean on in their moments of defeat. For being a lighthouse for our students, Archbishop Stepanak High School is pleased to present Mrs. Cynthia Kilkelly with the Block S Award. Our second Block S Award is being presented to Coach Nick Mitchell. If anyone has had the chance to work with Coach Mitchell, they are always asked at the first meeting a very specific and odd question. Can a rock talk? For the last 10 years, Nick has been asking this question, which has nothing to do with track and field per se. However, it is an integral piece of his coaching philosophy. That philosophy is simple. Faith, family, and passion for track and field. His compassionate and energetic work ethic is something that his athletes value and will never forget. It is clear that Coach Mitchell's faith is what drives him, and if you've ever had the chance to work with him, it is something that will undoubtedly inspire and stay with you forever. So yes, Coach, a rock can talk, because all things are possible with God. For all that he does so faithfully for our student athletes, Archbishop Stephanie High School is pleased to present him with the Block S. If you are taking pictures this afternoon, please keep the center area free. Also, if there are relatives who are alumni of Stepanak and have already notified you that they will present the diploma to the graduate, I ask that you watch closely for when his row begins to move out. At that time, please make your way to the podium next to me so that you will be ready to make the presentation. Father Collins, members of the Board of Trustees, the following students, upon satisfactory completion of the course of study prescribed by Archbishop Stepanak High School, will be entitled to diplomas. Father Collins, I'd ask at this time that you confer the title of graduate upon these young men. Also, each graduate is receiving with his diploma today a special letter of congratulations from His Eminence, Timothy Michael Cardinal Dolan, and a special recognition certificate for each graduate from Mayor Mike Spano, who is with us today. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Noah Abraham. Anthony Albanese. Brandon Alberghini Davis. This would be a good time for me to tell a joke. Didn't give you your diploma yet, did I? James Albertelli. Joseph Alfredo. Joshua Anderson. Jalen Barr. Dermot Bean. Kieran Bean. Mr. Dennis Benedict, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2010, and Mr. Zach Benedict, graduate of the class of 2014, and brothers of Stephen, will present the diploma to Stephen Benedict. Justin Bernhard. Matthew Butel, Mr. Eric Butel, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2006, will present the diploma to his brother, Matthew Butel. Michael Bellata. Guys, welcome. Lewis Blackwell. Robert Bach. Jaden Bonet. Cesare Bonilla. Andrew Bosch. Gene Brown Jr. Brian Buckley. Mr. Daniel Bonacore, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2012, will present the diploma to his brother, Timothy Bonacore. Dominique Burke. Leonardo Camaj. Abdul Karim Tamara. George Carballo III. Nicholas Carbone. Mr. Gerard Mead, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1956 and grandfather of Matthew, and Mr. Anthony Correccia, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2013, brother of Matthew, will present the diploma to Matthew Correccia. Mr. Vincent Foco, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2013, and Mr. Anthony Foco, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2014, will present the diploma to their cousin, Robert Carosa. Juan Carpenzano. Joseph Carini. Mr. Vito Castellano, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1985, will present the diploma to his son, Anthony Castellano. Marcos Castillo. Yancy Castro. Nicholas Serratani. Seth Champlin. Brendan Chapp. Giancarlo Colaiacovo. This is going to take a minute. Mr. John Collins, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1980, and John Collins' uncles, Father Tom Collins from the class of 79, Joe Collins from the class of 81, together with his brother, Mr. Christian Collins from the class of 2015, his cousins, Joseph Collins Jr., 09, Michael Collins, 11, Christopher Collins, 16, will present the diploma to John Collins. Giovanni Corelli. Mr. John Cunningham, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1955, will present the diploma to his grandson, Luke Cunningham. Dylan Curran. Mr. Nicholas D'Addario from the class of 2016 will present the diploma to his brother, Bernard D'Addario. Mr. Patsy D'Ambrosio, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2015, will present the diploma to his brother, Nicholas D'Ambrosio. Thomas Davaris. Mr. Joseph DeSanctis, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2015, will present the diploma to his brother, Mark DeSanctis. Jared DeLala. Richard DeVille Salvo. Say Dong. He's not here, so he's out here. Out of order. Salvatore DeRosa. Lawrence Donahue. Joseph Donovan III. Christopher Duke. Joseph Dwyer. Andrew Ernest. Zhizhong Feng. Mr. Robert Flood, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1987, will present the diploma to his son, Robert Flood. Timothy Flynn. Prince Forson. Mr. Vincent Foucault, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2013, and Mr. Anthony Foucault, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2014, cousins of Robert Carroza, will present the diploma to their brother, Michael Foucault. Noah Gaffney. Christopher Garceau. Brandon Gaspari. Christopher Gentle Steele. Mr. Vincent Capignoli, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1981, will present the diploma to his nephew, Antonio Giannico. Mirsad Jambalai. Jonathan Gomez. Jordan Gonzalez. Mr. Ian Hamilton, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2013, will present the diploma to his brother, Shamar Hamilton. Mr. Nick Cannon, graduate of the class of 2015, will present the diploma to his brother, John Hannon. Vidal Harrington. Brandon Hermosa Ricci. Henry Houston. Makai Johnson. William Jordan. Chan Kim. Minsa Kim. Daniel Kimmel. Lawrence Labriola. Marco Lagana. Ethan Lawson. Julio Lazo. Juliang Liu. Christian Lukovic. Nua Lujirai. Pablo Lojano. Patrick Magliocchino. Sean Mahoney. Jack Maish. Brian Manfredonia. Mr. Robert Markolovic, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2014, will present the diploma to his brother, David Markolovic. Anthony Marico. Elias Martinez. Josh Martinez. Mr. David Hudson, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1991, will present the diploma to his nephew, Tyler Main. Mr. Sean McDade, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2008, will present the diploma to his brother, Joseph McDade. Michael McFadden. Brandon McGarry. Andrew McManus. Jordan Means. Mr. Valbon Mayhai, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2013, brother of Vitan, and Mr. Albert Mayhai, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2014, and Mr. Alir Mahovic, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2006, cousins of Vitan, will present the diploma to Vitan Mayhai. Mr. Skyler Mercado, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2013, will present the diploma to his brother, Austin Mercado. Diego Mercado. Mr. T.J. Granada, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1998, will present the diploma to his cousin, Philip Malazzo. Jalen Mills. Daniel Modad. Mr. John Morello Sr., Stepanak graduate of the class of 1988, will present the diploma to his son, John Morello. Thomas Moreno. Christopher Morgan. Devante Miles. Mr. Thomas Nevin, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1982, will present the diploma to his son, Thomas Nevin. Timothy O'Connor, Jr. Mr. Malik Omez, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2013, will present the diploma to his cousin, Roy Omez, Jr. This is one of those amusing, awkward moments. Mr. Rory O'Neill, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2011, will present the diploma to his brother, Daniel O'Neill. Alejandro Ortiz LeBron. Gerard Palladino. Matthew Palmieri. Arturo Palomino. Dominic Patapio. Alexander Pate. Mr. Christian Perez, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2011, sends his best wishes to his cousin, Ernie Perez. Zachary Peterson. Marco Petruzzi. Anthony Pietro Luongo. Johnny Pimentel. Isaiah Powell. Mr. Ralph Ferrardi, Jr., Stepanak graduate of the class of 1985, will present the diploma to his nephew, Domenico Procopio. John Quinonez. Mr. Connor Rafferty, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2015, will present the diploma to his brother, Shane Rafferty. Matthew Ralph. Steve Ramos. Devante Reed. Mr. Nicholas Reed, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2012, will present the diploma to his brother, Peter Reed. Matthew Renna. Michael Rizzo. Mr. Michael Rocco, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1986, will present the diploma to his son, Alexander Rocco. Jonathan Rodriguez. Alfonso Romano. Matthew Rule. Anthony Russo Jr. Michael Ryan. Anthony Salza. Luke Shrivestein. Marshall Shett. Mattingly Simon. John Sofilis. Mark Spadassini. Michael Spano. Dominic Squillanti. Robert Sullivan. Edward Sunshine. Nicholas Tobio. John Tarassiano. Mr. Stephen Terrio, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1987. Will present the diploma to his son, Michael Terrio. Pierce Timko. Mr. Brendan West, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2011 and brother of Kieran, and Mr. Christopher Ryan, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1980 and uncle of Kieran, will present the diploma. Marcus Vasquez. Mr. Juan Carlos Villalobos, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2015, will present the diploma to his brother, Eddie Villalobos. John Huxanai. Edward Wall IV. John Walsh. Mr. Christopher Fox, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2002. Mr. Michael Fox, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2005. Mr. Kevin Moore Jr., Stepanak graduate of the class of 2006. And Mr. Maximilian Moore, Stepanak graduate of the class of 2014, will present the diploma to their brother, Sean Moore. Mr. Marty Weinbaum, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1983, and Mr. Anthony Ravelli, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1994, will present the diploma to their nephew, James Weinbaum. Ryan Wilkins. Tiger Winston. Isaiah Wright. Jingtung Zhu. Michael Zerbo. Christopher Zettel. Ziyi Zhang. Three particular awards that will be distributed today deserve an explanation. The Archbishop Stepanak Presidential Award is given to students who have offered exceptional service to our school community by consistently volunteering their time and talent. The Archbishop Stepanak Principals Award is presented for academic excellence to the top 10 academically ranked students. The following graduates have been selected as recipients of special honors and awards. I ask that you hold your applause for these graduates until the end of all the awards have been read. Thank you. Mr. Anthony Albanese, the National Honor Society Certificate, and the Reverend James Cashman, Scholarship. Joseph Alfredo, the Reverend Hargrove Award for Dramatics. Dermot Behan, the National Honor Society Certificate, the New York State Scholarship for Academic Excellence, the St. Michael's College Book Award, and the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence. Kieran Behan, the National Honor Society Certificate. Justin Bernhard, the AP Scholar Award. Michael Bellotta, the National Honor Society Certificate, the Excellence in History Award, the American Legion Scholarship, the Columbia University Book Award, the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence, and the AP Scholar Award. Cesare Bonilla, the National Honor Society Certificate, and the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence. Andrew Bosch, who has already received the New York State Attorney General Triple C Award. Congratulations. Brian Buckley, the National Honor Society Certificate. Timothy Bonacore, the Excellence in Latin Award, the Campus Ministry Award, the Reverend Hargrove Award for Dramatics, and the President's Award for Service. Dominique Burke, the Campus Ministry Award, the Major Bowes Scholarship, the National Choral Award, and the President's Award for Service. Nicholas Carbone, the National Honor Society Certificate, and the President's Award for Service. Juan Carpenzano, the Varsity 3 Sport Award. Marcos Castillo, the Reverend Hargrove Award for Dramatics and the President's Award for Service. Giancarlo Polyakova, the National Honor Society Certificate and the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence. John Paul Collins, the National Honor Society Certificate and the President's Award for Service. Giovanni Corelli, the National Honor Society Certificate. Luke Cunningham, the Campus Ministry Award. Bernard Daddario, the National Honor Society Certificate. Nicholas D'Ambrosio, the National Honor Society Certificate, the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence. Mark DeSantis, the National Honor Society. Yeah, hi, remember after we read off the interview? Mark DeSantis, the National Honor Society Certificate, the Excellence in Literature Award, the Excellence in Vocal Music, the Richard Nagel Theater Scholarship, and the President's Award for Service. Lawrence Donahue, the National Honor Society Certificate. And a book. Joseph Donovan III, the President's Award for Service. Christopher Duke, the Hargrove Award for Dramatics. Zhijian Feng, the National Honor Society Certificate, the White Plains Rotary Scholarship, the Excellence in Computer Science, the Certificate of Special Congressional Recognition, the Moody's MegaMath Challenge Semifinalist, the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence, and the AP Scholar with Honors Award. Robert Flood, the National Honor Society Certificate. Timothy Flynn, the President's Award for Service. Prince Forsen, the Varsity Free Sport Award and the Campus Ministry Award. Christopher Garceau, the National Honor Society Certificate. Christopher Gentle Steele, the Hargrove Award for Dramatics. Antonio Giannico, the August Colarusso MVP Award. Vidal Harrington, the Excellence in Instrumental Music. Brandon Hermosa Ricci, the National Honor Society Certificate and the President's Award for Service. Henry Houston, the Varsity Free Sport Award. William Jordan, the White Plains Rotary Scholarship, the President's Award for Service, the St. Vincent's Youth Leadership Award, and the North Salem Lions Club Community Service Scholarship. Chan Kim, the National Honor Society Certificate. Min-Suk Kim, the National Honor Society Certificate. Marco Lagana, the National Honor Society Certificate. Julio Lazo, the National Honor Society Certificate, the New York State Scholarship for Academic Excellence, the Excellence in Science Award, the Harvard Book Award, the President's Award for Service, the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence, and the AP Scholar Award. Patrick Magliocino, the National Honor Society Certificate, the St. Michael's College Book Award, the National Merit Scholarship Program Commendation, and the AP Scholar Award. David Markolovic, the National Honor Society Certificate, the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence. Andrew McManus, the President's Award for Service. Diego Mercado, the National Honor Society Certificate, the Excellence in Religious Studies Award, and the Hargrove Award for Dramatics. What? John Morello, the National Honor Society Certificate. Thank you. Javante Miles, the Excellence in Physical Education Award. Thomas Nevin, the National Honor Society Certificate, the Patrick Grimes Award, the Choquette Trophy Award, the Ronald Reagan Student Leader Award, the Moody Mega Math Challenge Semifinalist, and the President's Award for Service. Yeah. Roy Omess Jr., the Varsity 3 Sport Award. Matthew Joseph Palmieri, the Guidance Department Award. Arturo Palomino, the President's Award for Service. Dominic Patafio, the National Honor Society Certificate, the New York State Scholarship for Academic Excellence, the Ronald Reagan Student Leader Award, the Quincy Jones Musicianship Award, the Harvard Radcliffe Club of Westchester Award, the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence, and the AP Scholar Award. Zachary Peterson, the National Honor Society Certificate. Anthony Pietro Luongo, the Excellence in Vocal Music Award, the Matt Stotsky Theater Scholarship, and the President's Award for Service. Isaiah Powell, the National Honor Society Certificate, and the White Plains Rotary Scholarship. Domenico Procopio, the National Honor Society Certificate, the Excellence in Italian Award, and the White Plains Rotary Scholarship. Devante Reed, the Varsity 3 Sport Award. Matthew Rule, the Campus Ministry Award. Luke Schreibstein, the Campus Ministry Award. Parshall Shett, the National Honor Society Certificate, the New York State Scholarship for Academic Excellence, the White Plains Rotary Scholarship, the Excellence in Instrumental Music, Excellence in Mathematics, the Victor Ritter Scholarship, the Holy Cross Book Award, the Ronald Reagan Student Leader Award, and the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence. Mattingly Simon, the National Honor Society Certificate and Excellence in Spanish Award. Michael Spano, the National Honor Society Certificate. Nicholas Tavio, the New York State Scholarship for Academic Excellence, the Bob Fitzsimmons Westchester Broadway Dinner Theater Scholarship, the Ronald Reagan Student Leader Award, the Harvard Book Club Award, the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence, National Merit Scholarship Program Commendation, National Hispanic Recognition Program, New York State Comptroller's Achievement Award. Jack Tarassiano, the Campus Ministry Award, the President's Award for Service, and the AP Scholar Award. Pierce Timko, the Reverend Hargrove Award for Dramatics. Kieran Tyrone, the National Honor Society Certificate and the White Plains Rotary Scholarship. Terrence Tunick, the National Honor Society Certificate, the Campus Ministry Award, the Moody's Mega Math Challenge Semifinalist, and the AP Scholar Award. John Walsh, the National Honor Society Certificate. Michael Zerbo, the Coach O'Grady Baseball Award. At this time, we will present some very special student awards and scholarships. When your name is called, please come to the front of the podium for the presentation of the award by Father Collins. First, the Richard Gordon Memorial Award. The Richard Gordon Memorial Award was established by the friends and family of Rick Gordon, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1967. The recipient is a graduating senior who, in the opinion of the faculty, has demonstrated courage, determination, sensitivity, and wit, and has earned the respect, admiration, and friendship of his fellow classmates. The 2017 Richard Gordon Award is presented to Anthony Pietro Luongo. The Lieutenant Ray Murphy Scholarships. The family of Lieutenant Ray Murphy, a firefighter who died at the World Trade Center, and whose son Sean is a Stepanak graduate of the class of 2005, decided to establish scholarships in Ray's memory. These awards are to be presented to seniors who have offered service to Stepanak and who are also sons of New York City firefighters. The 2017 Lieutenant Ray Murphy Memorial Scholarships are presented to Austin Mercado and Joseph Donovan. The Frank Becerra Spirit in Sports Scholarship. Frank Becerra, an alumni father, was a true sports fan in every sense of the word. He loved to watch sports on TV, go to games, talk about sports, and most of all, draw any type of sports teams, personalities, or events. He was delighted when one of the Con Ed Award winners was a Stepanak student, since these drawings were really drawn from his heart. He was very proud of the fact that all five of his sons graduated from Stepanak. He would attend any sporting event that he could, even if his sons were not on that team. He could be found at Stepanak games long after his sons graduated. His favorite event is the annual Turkey Bowl game against his alma mater, White Plains High School. He drew the cover of the program for this annual event. He was the ultimate true fan of Stepanak sports. In memory of Frank, the Becerra family will be presenting a Spirit in Sports Scholarship each year to a graduating senior who has been the ultimate fan of Stepanak sports. The eighth recipient of the scholarship is Mr. Philip Malazzo. The Joseph Reverso Memorial Scholarships. The family of Joe Reverso, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1985, who died at the World Trade Center, decided to establish scholarships in Joe's memory. Joe was a Stepanak football coach for many years, so these scholarships are presented to students who best exemplify the qualities that Joe lived throughout his life: dedication to his sport, teamwork, and loyalty to Stepanak. The Joseph Reverso Football Scholarships are presented to Antonio Giannico, Tommy Nevin, Isaiah Powell, and John Walsh. Joseph also loved the game of golf, and so the Joe Reverso Golf Scholarship is presented to John Paul Collins. The Donald Broderick Memorial Scholarship. The Donald Broderick Memorial Scholarship is named in honor of Donald Broderick, Stepanak graduate of the class of 1982. Donald was tragically killed in a car accident in September of 1986. His family started a scholarship for a student planning on attending Manhattan College, who best demonstrates Donald's strong sense of determination, his charm, sincere compassion, and deep-rooted Christian values. The recipients of this year's Donald Broderick Memorial Scholarship are Terrence Tunick and Arturo Palomino. the William E. Plunkett Award. In 1998, in celebration of the golden anniversary, Archbishop Stepanek High School established a new graduation award, the William F. Plunkett Award. The inscription on the plaque reads as follows. The William Plunkett Award is presented to a graduate of Archbishop Stepanek High School who has displayed in an outstanding manner the qualities of academic excellence, service to others, and school spirit. The award is named for Bill Plunkett, a graduate of the class of 1958, who is a well-respected and gifted lawyer who continues to be supportive and generous to his alma mater. An advisor to cardinals, governors, and community leaders, Bill is a role model of the values for which this award is bestowed. This year, the William Plunkett Awards are presented to Thomas Nevin and Nicholas Tavia. The Blanche Alfaro Marinelli Scholarship. Blanche Alfaro Marinelli was a Westchester resident who, upon her death, created a trust fund to be used for college scholarships for seniors graduating from Archbishop Stepanek High School. The candidate must be a student in good standing, one who has contributed to the Stepanek community by his involvement in extracurricular activities, involvement in community service, and meeting the needs of those who are less fortunate. This year, the recipient of this scholarship is Brandon Hermosa Ricci. As of May 22nd, the total amount of scholarships and grants allocated for our senior class is $29 million. The Order of the Crusader Award. 18 years ago, we announced the establishment of the Order of the Crusader so that Stepanek might honor graduates and staff who were exceptional in offering their time and talent to our school. Induction into the order requires the individual to faithfully dedicate themselves to our school and to her spirit, and to consistently display an extraordinary love for Stepanek through many acts of service above and beyond the call of duty. Membership in the Order of the Crusader is limited. This is to ensure that inductees are individuals who have earned the respect of both faculty and peers. They must also be recognized by all in the community as individuals whose loyalty to Stepanek is unquestioned and who have demonstrated this loyalty through countless acts of service. This year's inductees fulfill that criteria. It is my pleasure to honor and to present the newest members of the Order of the Crusader: Dominique Burke, Mark DeSantis, Christopher Gentle Steele, Thomas Nevin, Dominic Patapio, Harshal Shett, Nicholas Tavio, and Terrence Tunick. We are also delighted to induct the following faculty members into the Order of the Crusader with sincere appreciation for all that they do for the school. And so we are pleased to induct Mr. Stephen Cupertino and Mr. Michael O'Donnell. Thank you. It is my pleasure to present Mr. Nicholas Tibbio, our valedictorian, who will deliver the farewell address.
Yes, now I understand that everybody has dinner reservations, so I'll do my best to keep it succinct and quick. So, with that in mind though, hello administrators, teachers, family, and the men of the hour, the class of 2017. First, a special thanks must go out to the teachers and administrators who decided to pass us, despite our lack of effort for the second semester. You guys are the real MVPs for that, and we thank you immensely for it. But seriously, thank you teachers for making Stepan Act the best 4 years of our young lives. Also, we must of course thank our parents, who all could have owned a renovated kitchen, a brilliant new car, or just had a larger bank account, but instead thought that $40,000 was best to be allocated to high school education. You took a risk on a gaggle of boys, and we cannot thank you enough for it. And now, class of 2017, I recognize that it is despicably uncomfortable in here, and that you have all listened to multiple speeches, heard a lot of awards, and all of these speeches, of course, being oddly reminiscent of Mr. Carty's lunchtime assemblies. But yet, despite the heat, the fatigue, and, of course, those upcoming dinner reservations, I beg your indulgence and attention for just 5 more minutes. I'll try not to add boredom to your plates. Throughout our lives, we have found and will continue to find that there is a lack of continuity in this world. Despite this universal condition, Stepanak High School has found its way to remain a constant in our lives over the last 4 years. Mr. Sunderland finds a way to hate every single student in the school every day in a new, creative, and hysterical way. Mr. Mara has kept his critically acclaimed mustache, despite the fact it makes him look like Albert Einstein and Mark Twain's long-lost brother. And of course, Mrs. Amato will never stop calling every single teacher in the school in the middle of class to see if someone's there. We, of course, were not. Even the building provides some degree of continuity as we are on the precipice of celebrating 70 years on 950 Mamaroneck Avenue. However, there are some facets of Stepanak that change on a nearly yearly basis, of course, including the student body, but none more change as frequently as the school uniform. In many ways, the uniform of our all-boys Catholic high school has defined our manhood. It is the one article of clothing that identifies you as willingly or unwillingly part of the all-boys environment. And since committing to this all-boys environment in the eighth grade, we have been faced with the great difficulty of justifying ourselves to our public school and co-ed friends. Lacking any immediate profound thoughts, we stumbled and blurted out the obvious answer. You get to be a guy. The vulgarity, the violence, the idiocy, the minimal hygiene, the emotional simplicity, without the daily worry and distraction of girls. All of us stood there, chests pumped out in our freshman year uniform. A feminine, uncomfortable sweater vest, which resembled a family portrait gone awry more than anything else. As freshman year passed, there was no hair gelling in the morning or wearing far too much Axe cologne. Of course, any Axe cologne is too much Axe cologne, but we didn't feel the need to impress anyone with our appearance, so we didn't even try. We all got to be guys, despite the fact we stood in said delicate, pretty vest with no facial hair, no height, no muscle, and no stature of any kind. And then the sophomore year came around. The feminine sweater vest was replaced with an Under Armour pullover, which made us look like a bunch of Lax bros. And it was the most comfortable uniform yet. With this new, more masculine look, we felt even more like guys, now primed for, and dare I say, girlfriends. Most of us had attempted to make waves in the world of romance at some of the school dances held at Stepanak, and most of us failed miserably. We were all a vile mix of the too much cologne and the too little cologne, and we all either had far too much pride preventing us from dancing, or far too little pride, which allowed us to look hysterically foolish on the dance floor, trying to perform the Dougie, the Cat Daddy, or to just grind all over the place, which of course forced Mr. Portnova to break us all up, adding room for the Holy Spirit in between the boys and the girls. Despite this horrible war flashback close in mind, we marched into the fray of romance, getting fresh cuts to impress the ladies, attempting to work out without any real athletic aspirations, and wearing clothes that weren't exclusively sweatpants and a sweatshirt. However, that did not deter us from our path. We still found ways to be the guys. And then finally, the day came when we were announced upperclassmen, and the new quarter zip marked another transition. It had a rather radical white line on the side, which everyone loved, depicting our evolution into a more stylish group of guys. Finally. As juniors, we were now able to openly intimidate underclassmen. I see a few of you up there. We were all beginning to drive, and the first stages of senioritis were already beginning to settle in. Yet despite the rigor of our junior year schedules, we still found time to be one of the guys. Sometimes it was just an energetic, vulgar, and hysterical conversation at lunch. Sometimes it was going to the football game and being part of the Stepanak jungle, a rambunctious and vulgar student section led by the one, the only, Phil Milazzo. And sometimes it was creating new and exciting ways to get detention in Mr. Mara's class. Then, senior year occurred. The uniform became the most comfortable yet. Entirely optional! For all of us, being one of the guys sure was easy when we all decided that senior homeroom started at 9 a.m. And we all left by 1:30 p.m. There was plenty of time to sell pool passes to the freshmen, take classes with the school's one and only force of nature, Mrs. Calvello, and catch up on all the romance and sleep that we had forgot about during junior year. However, college process threw us a curveball. We were unprecedentedly asked to discuss our emotions for all the world to see. How could they ask us from an all-boys school, now men at this point, to engage in such an unattractive activity? Many of us saw this expression of emotion as a strictly feminine concept. Given our hyper-masculine concept of manhood at the time, we struggled throughout the emotional and seemingly feminine process of writing about our thoughts, our dreams, the stories that make up our lives. Therefore, not surprisingly, these attempts were stuttering, ridiculous shambles. Of course, there was a sense of pride that we were becoming more and more masculine, able to reject such frivolous emotions, preventing many of us, myself of course included, from writing beautiful, poignant essays. But despite the hollow essays, we made it. A group of graduates bound for college. A real group of guys, a group of students taught scholarship, a group of princes crowned kings, a group of warriors championed as victors. However, my fellow graduates, scholars, kings, victors, my fellow guys, I'm ashamed to say I don't really know any of you all that well. No, I look at faces of men and see great stories, the funniest of jokes, thrilling sports events, and inspiring theatrical performances. However, I know little about almost any of you. I never asked any of you what you fear, what your dreams are, what your favorite hobbies are. I never confided in you when I was at my worst, nor did I celebrate when I was at my best. We rarely held discourse about our views on the universe, the inevitability of time, the fears of the next steps of life, the nature of man and the nature of our manhood. No, instead of acting on some of our less masculine human emotions, we used jokes, vulgarity, cruelty as a facade. As poet Paul Laurence Dunbar appropriately describes, we wore the mask that grinned and lied. It hid our cheeks and shaded our eyes. This debt we pay to human guile, with torn and bleeding hearts we smile and mouth myriad subtleties. Yes, we wore this mask, which rarely showed true sympathy or empathy to one another. A mask that seldom allowed us to express our feelings to one another. That prevented us from hearing and feeling the emotions of one another. And yet we chose to wear this mask willingly, and we mutually and unspokenly understood why we made this choice. We simply had to. We simply had to wear this Under Armour mask if we were to be one of the guys. We all have a few months before we go to college. However, it must crucially be remembered that we are all lifetime members of the Stepanak family. And over the next few months and years, as we enter the ranks of alumni, I encourage us all, myself included, to really speak openly with one another. I want to know everything about my best friends. I want to ask all the questions I never got a chance to ask during the years. And I want to hear and remember every single answer. Patrick, Mike, Johnny, I want to know and talk about friendship and figure out how your brilliant Westlake trio finds some way to seem so everlasting. Mark, your daily and unceasing smile makes me question my own daily cynicism. And I want to know how that smile could appear on anyone's face so frequently. And to all my friends, I want to know why you, me, and so many of the guys here refuse to express any emotion or ask for help when we need it. I want to hear the difficult answers from you all. I want the difficult questions asked of me. I want to hold dear the words of Sigmund Freud that in human beings, pure masculinity or femininity is not to be found either in a psychological or biological sense. And when I doubt this, I want to remember that before we are men and women, we are first human beings. Therefore, with this in mind, I simply refuse to accept the definition of manhood that has been conveyed by my actions in the last 4 years. Manhood is not just the vulgarity, the great jokes. Manhood is not taunting teachers, bullying students, and creating general mayhem. Manhood is not the extreme development of a purely masculine being. No. No, true manhood is much more complex than that. True manhood is the ability to find the balance between empathy and barbarous humor. True manhood is thinking about expressing a perfectly timed, cruel joke and instead refraining and maintaining some degree of self-control. Manhood is the ability to be comfortable with expressing emotions and interpreting the emotions of others. Yes. Yes, true manhood incorporates the mayhem, the vulgarity, the idiocy, all of which I personally love. Yet, these facets of manhood are far from the limit. And despite how many times we will be told today that now we are men, I hope we all reject that notion together. Instead, I hope we all see before us a great opportunity, a call to arms, a true battle cry. I hope that in life, we find moments in life to shed the Under Armour and expose the emotions vested within us and wear them with the utmost pride. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to present to you the president of Archbishop Stepanak High School, the Reverend Thomas Collins.
That is a tough act to follow. You know, as president, I am privileged to all kinds of communication. Communication from the students, communication from the parents, communication from the alumni, communication from the community. I have a letter here that was written just a couple weeks ago. It was written to really all of Stepanak. I just had the pleasure to be able to see it. He starts by saying, I thought that my days at Stepanak had come to a closure with my graduation, but recently I realized that this is never the case from anyone who benefited from a Stepanak education. For this very reason, I must say thank you to all. Thank you for teaching me and reminding me who I am and what I am capable of achieving. For several months, I was starting to lose pieces of myself due to the way that I was viewed and treated by my current peers. This poor young man graduated within the last 3 years was being bullied emotionally, verbally, he was being ostracized. Then I reached out for help and received the support and the assistance that was always available to me when I was at Stepanak. It revived me as the person that I once was before graduation. By reaching back, I have been given the chance to feel good about myself and know that I am accepted by others. Stepanak Health has made me cherish the moment and every moment that I was a student. Most importantly, it is wonderful to see that Stepanak is a place for everyone to feel they are a part of something. And that something would be the Stepanak family. So I thank you all for reminding me of what it means to be a part of the Stepanak family. I will continue with my life remembering the importance of Stepanak and all that I learned while I was there. He lists, Stepanak will be a place that I can always call home. Stepanak has made it possible for me to accomplish anything. I will walk proud and strong as a Stepanak crusader. I know I will always have Stepanak friends and family to be supported by and to give my support to them. And Stepanak and my experience at Stepanak will never leave me. Thank you. Congratulations to you, class of 2017. I was going to say 79. That's the most important year. 2017. And to your families, many blessings upon you for this weekend. May the Lord look upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord in his kindness grant you peace. And may the blessings of Almighty God descend upon you and be with you always. In God's holy name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
The class of 1983 rules. As our recession is playing, Father Collins will proceed down the center aisle, followed by our graduates. Please remain in your places until they have passed by. We thank you for your participation in our ceremony and wish you much joy as you continue your celebration today.
I've been seeing you around, don't worry. I've been on. Congratulations, guys.
It wasn't easy, 5 years late.
Not easy, not easy.
Obviously.
What?